go over on Ireland, you should clean your steel in preparation for welding, and why it's important to do, and what factors should be taken into account. So anyway, let's discuss some basics. So we have this piece of steel, and as you see, it's got paint on it. And we have this piece of steel that has quite a lot of rust on it. And my intention is to, simplistically say, I want to put those two together. And the one crucial part to remember about welding is that it's the welding that starts from here. Stick here, and the current comes along this lead here and goes along the stick, and then it wants to strike an arc. And then if you're welding along here, for example, then the arc will jump into the metal, and it'll jump into the metal that is clean, it has the, or the part of the metal that has the lowest conductivity. And not only that, it'll jump into the metal that the return or grounding connector is connected to. So there are various kind of ground connection things in this cheap stick welding unit. It's not exactly a very good one. So this would actually be rather dependent on being able to, you need to be able to fasten it on that clean piece of metal, otherwise this probably won't work. There are grounding clamps which have like flat copper bits and stuff, and the more expensive ones, and then they get a bigger area to connect. But the most important thing to remember is that you have to, the most advantageous part to connect this to is to the, what I would call the main part to be welded to. So we'll do this one, for example. So that would mean that we need to be able to connect this to a part that is away from all the heat, but still gives a good conductive path. So let's clean this one up and connect it there. And I want to start welding. So then, once these two metal parts are clean, I try and strike, and the current will go through the metal all the way back there. And if this is clean, then this will also get enough conductivity. The hope is that then the current generated arc will actually jump to both materials and combine them, and then you get to add the metal from the electrode, and then you can just weld it. There won't be any some funny stuff. I mean, if the components of the welding system, either here or here at the contact point or down here, has inconsistent connectivity or conductivity, then that will lead to, for example, this welds at a very fixed, it tries to weld at a very fixed voltage, and mean that you get a lot of voltage, a lot of resistance in this part here. So, we have this. Stop cleaning off this box. Connect to the ground or to turn up to, and the actual areas that are going to be welded. Cool. Well, that's that. We could connect the turn cable now for this one. Those both sides are on the inside, and that's going to be welded on. It's not bent, so it's not bent. Also cleaned on this side, so the clamp can actually clamp on conductor wise from the. On both sides. Well, I think that's okay. And now it's just clean this one off. There's going to be three of those, so it's going to be one here, one over there, so this all needs to end up. I'm not using a dust mask because I'm one outside, and then there's a wind blowing. Hope you don't hear it in the microphone too. It's clean. All the rust, oh, most of the rust and all. I mean, if there's a little bit of tiny rust left, that'll burn through, you know, actually, to be honest. But if one can get it to that level of cleanliness, it makes the welding process a bit easier. So anyway, there are one more of these and two more of those supports to do. I won't bore you with that. So anyway, hope you found that informative. If you thought it was, then consider hitting the like button. If you want to see this stuff being welded together, then consider subscribing and viewing all the upcoming episodes, and I'll hopefully see you in the next one.